The Police, the Synchronicity Concert, captures in vision and full stereo sound a performance staggering even by police standards. And you are there.
So let's go!
With worldwide record sales exceeding 30 million, the world's greatest band performed their greatest hits live. 75 minutes of music, including Grammy Award winner Every Breath You Take. Wrapped Around Your Finger, Message in a Bottle, and 12 other Police classics. Staging, lighting, and direction of the film are imaginative, inventive, and achieve total sympathy with the music, establishing a new standard in live presentation. Sting, Andy Summers, Stuart Copeland, The Police, the Synchronicity Concert. An A&M Video IRS Video joint release, available in VHS Hi-Fi and Beta Hi-Fi, distributed by RCA Columbia Pictures Home Video.
The Police wound up their Synchronicity World Tour in front of 50,000 people last Sunday in Melbourne. This was Australia's biggest ever international rock concert and the last Police concert for at least 2 years. And now acting as Master of Ceremonies, the beat of the Police, the extremely well-versed Mr. Stuart Copeland.
A performance by the famous Royal Australian Aboriginal Kangaroos, who will be performing the Balalaiki dance as indicated in Rachmaninoff's third movement of his famous symphony dedicated to Horatio Algernon, who, as we all know, was a great culinary expert who designed incredible high-tech analog versions of spaghetti mix.
Stuart, welcome again to Countdown. This time in Melbourne at a most amazing site.
What a great day.
Yeah, fantastic. Now listen, the last concert for 2 years, they say. Is it going to be?
Well, 2 years, 3 years, yeah. 6 months. You know, tried it before, as a matter of fact.
Where did that decision, was it a joint decision by the three of you or what?
Yeah, it was. Various times, various ideas have come up for work for us to do, mix the live album or do this show or that show.
Right.
But we've kind of, we think about it because we're in a good mood now. We're feeling right. Very positive, very optimistic, and we're getting along well, and band morale is very high. So we're kind of ready to kind of take on stuff, but then we think, no. Huh. And we pull back, and so we have no studio time booked, no concerts booked, nothing booked.
It just seems amazing of where, I mean, there's always the old saying, you should always go out on a high. Well, I mean, there can't be a bigger high. I mean, the album Synchronicity 2, but I mean, Synchronicity has been an amazing success, 4 Grammys. I mean, and all
have
of this.
Have you figured out what they're for yet?
I think it's 4.
We know there's 4 of them. Right. We don't know what he got them for.
So, and there's no recording, no nothing. Are you going into some individual recording? Yeah. Can you tell us about it?
Well, it's. I'll tell you about when I've done it.
All right. Well, listen, you've given us great pleasure. over the years.
You've given us great pleasure.
You've had some weird titles that us people have had to get our tongues around, I might add, like Synchronicity 2 and Regatta and do-do-do-do-da-da-da-da. I've got it this time, yes.
Okay, Stewie, let's have a look at your new single, King of Pain.
Sure.
And a good show tonight as well.
So long and so forth.
There's a little black spot on the sun today.
Hello, Andy. Welcome to Countdown. Again.
Great to be here.
Thank God you've got simple song titles. That's all I can say these days.
Yes.
Right. Listen, we spoke to Stuart before.
Mm-hmm.
It seems incredible that a band that started off for such a long time ago as sort of like a band that was in England, unknown in America, hailed as one of the great English bands, and then you make a decision to decide at the pinnacle, I'd say, at the moment, to call it a day for a while.
Well, I think we should clear up this point about calling it a day. You know, we're not really calling it a day. We've been on the road for 7 years. We've been on the road currently for 7 months without a break. This is the end of this tour. We just think it's time for sabbatical.
Right.
To really keep the group alive, or any group really, you have to take time off at this point to rethink what you're doing and think about
it. Has it been relentless as far as living is concerned? I mean, you've brought out album after album, and none of them have been a failure. Has that been a sort of relentless part of everyone demanding for you to do something else?
Yeah, I mean, in a sense, we created our own monster.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, I think we all have a sort of workaholic nature individually, but the group collectively has always wanted to make it very much,
right,
and try to better what we've done before. But that makes people want you to keep on doing it, and then you find you've kind of created a vicious circle, and somehow you have to get out of that so that you can kind of find a new way of coming back at it.
Was the decision made about having a break before you released Synchronicity or after? Because, I mean, Synchronicity has been an amazing success,
yeah,
for a lot of reasons, you know?
No, I think that we sort of, I mean, planned to sort of make this album and do all the world tour,
right,
that would be right for it and give it its best shot,
right,
and then take some time off. I mean, actually, you know, on this point, we are planning to go back into the studio in December,
right,
of this year, which is not that long, really, is it? It's only, I mean, 8 or 9 months, 10 months,
yeah,
now to make a live album, and then we'll see after that.
Well, as I say, thanks for coming on the show. Well, it's nearly the end of the show, and it's about the start of your show, the final for 2 years. I've spoken to Stuart and Andy. It seems hard to believe.
What did they say?
They said they sort of went around it.
Yeah. I think it's going to be very emotional tonight. I mean, it's not a... up for it, you know, and I don't know how I feel.
Right. Now, I mean, like, going back to when I first met you, and when the English press were hailing you as the face of the 80s, I know you used to hate that sort of publicity, but a lot have fallen by the wayside since then. I mean, like, perhaps the Boomtown Rats. The Police just kept going from strength to strength. What do you think has been the real success of the three of you?
I think we had something in depth, you know. It's very easy to have an initial success just on,
right,
the surface level, but once you get underneath, you've got to have something there to last, you know.
Right.
And I was watching Elton John last night, and he's got that kind of quality in depth, you know, and he'll go forever.
No,
so I hope we do.
Well, it's funny, I mean, just looking at you last night, I hadn't seen you for a while. With all the publicity that you individually got, is that hard to cop and to live up to? Or did you just turn your back on it?
I don't really take much notice of it, you know. I don't sort of scan the newspapers for stories about,
right,
myself, you know. So I tend to ignore it. They're not writing about me, they're writing about some manufactured...
But it was pretty strong, wasn't it, the press, the way
terrible.
Yeah. So what for the next 2 years then?
Oh, lots of different things. Lots,
yeah,
of, you know, might get a job on a milk round or...
Yeah?
Who knows?
Acting? What about that?
I've got just got a great movie.
Right.
No.
I won't ask about it. All right. Listen, as I say, I've had a lot of fun over the years. You've given me, and I know a lot of people in Australia, a lot of enjoyment, and indeed the world with your records. I just want to say congratulations.
Thanks, Willie.